أكبر الله.
You mentioned that Maoulana and Reza of Allah was asked, who are those that are firmly rooted in knowledge? Who are firmly rooted in knowledge? Yeah, what that means is that in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ. There are some people who are dedicated and they are 100% into knowledge. So Abu Dawud went to the Prophet ﷺ and asked that, what is the meaning of this ayah? What is the meaning of those people? Who are those people that are firmly rooted in knowledge? How can we tell them? That's what the Prophet ﷺ said. Yeah? Whoever's oath is true, whose tongue is truthful, whose heart is upstanding, whose stomach and pride of hearts abstain, and this person is firmly rooted. These are all the things. You want to see a person that firmly rooted in knowledge, dedicated in knowledge, he has the true essence of knowledge, you see these characteristics in him. Whenever he makes a promise, he makes it happen. If he has his tongue is also true, he never lies. His heart is upstanding, his heart is clean. Yeah? As we say, knowledge is not all about numbers, it's not all about facts, it's not all about how many hadith we could say, it's not all about how many opinions we could bring. It's not how much we could give so much information to people. Knowledge is about fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why it says that if you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's sufficient knowledge. Yeah? Fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient knowledge. That's why Imam Malik, there's this one person during the time of Imam Malik, and he was Al-Khalqi. He wasn't a scholar, he was a spiritual Sufi person. So someone came to him and said, after you go, Imam Malik, who shall we go to study, right? Then Imam Malik said, that person, go to Khalqi. But the person said, this person, he doesn't know much knowledge, he doesn't have much information. He's not like a big time, as we say, he's not like a big person. Yeah? Imam Malik said, he's got one knowledge that other people don't have. That is, he fears Allah, and that's sufficient. Yeah? He fears Allah, which is knowledge. So he's not all about numbers and facts. Yeah? His stomach, he eats halal food, and private parts abstain. Yeah? This person is firmly rooted in knowledge. And it's mentioned in At-Tabari, okay?